Are there any animal analogs?
I believe that self-deception has evolved in two situations, at least, in other creatures. And I believe it could be studied. I've suggested a way to do it, but nobody's done it. When you are making an evaluation of another animal in a combat situation, the other organism's sense of self-confidence is a relevant factor in your combat situation. The other organism's sense of self-confidence is a relevant factor in your evaluation. You can imagine selection for overconfidence. Confidence. Selection for suppressing.
For showing overconfidence, even if it's not real.
Exactly. Likewise, in situations of courtship, where females are evaluating men. Exactly. Or suppressing.
For showing overconfidence.
Overconfidence. Selection for suppressing.
For showing overconfidence, even if.
Overconfidence. Selection for suppressing.
For showing overconfidence, even if it's not real.
Exactly. Likewise, in situations of courtship.
Are there any animal analogs?
I believe that self-deception has evolved in two situations.
Are there any animal analogs?
I believe that self-deception has evolved in two situations, at least, in other creatures. And I believe it could be studied. I've suggested in two situations, at least, in other creatures. And I believe it could be studied. I've suggested a way to do it, but nobody's done it. When you are making an evaluation of another animal in a combat situation, the other organism's sense of self-confidence is a relevant factor in your evaluation. You can imagine selection for overconfidence, selection for suppressing...
For showing overconfidence. Even if it's not real.
Exactly. Likewise, in situations of courtship.
Showing overconfidence, even if it's not real.
Exactly. Likewise, in situations of courtship, where...
Confidence, even if it's not real.
Exactly. Likewise, in situations... instances of courtship, where females are evaluating males. And again, the organism's sense of self is a relevant parameter. You can have selection without language, it seems to me. Four biased kinds of information flow within the organism to keep up a false front.
It may be that the animal that's putting up a false front knows it's a false front.
Indeed, but it may benefit from not knowing it. Easier to do it and perhaps more convincing. Easier to do it and perhaps more convincing because you're not giving away evidence.
Secondary signs. Just speculation.
What you heard is rank speculation. I do not know of anybody who's doing it on self-deception. There's excellent work being done on deception in other creatures. To give you just one line of work there that is done on deception in other creatures, self-deception. There's excellent work being done on deception in other creatures. To self-deception. There's excellent work being done on deception in other creatures. Other creatures. To give you just one line of work there that is of some interest. repeatedly what we find now in wasps, in birds, and in monkeys. That organisms, when they realize they're being deceived, get, and in monkeys, that organisms, when they realize they're being deceived, in birds, and in monkeys, that organisms, when they realize they're being deceived, get, pissed off, forgive my English, they often attack the deceiver, but especially if the deceiver is overrepresenting him or herself. If you're underrepresenting and showing yourself as having less, dominance than you really have or whatnot, underrepresenting, and especially if the deceiver is overrepresenting him or herself. If you're underrepresenting and showing yourself as having less dominance than you really have or whatnot, you're not. And the ones that attack you are precisely those whose dominance status you are attempting to expropriate or mimic. It's very interesting, and it suggests some of the dynamic in which, you know, in which fear of being detected in which fear of being detected while deceiving can be a secondary signal, precisely because if you are detected, you may get your butt kicked or you may get chased out.
There's even a name for that in the international affairs literature. It's called maintaining credibility. There's even a name for that in the international affairs literature. It's called maintaining credibility. in the international affairs literature. It's called maintaining credibility.
Uh-huh.
So you have to carry out violent acts to maintain credibility.
Indeed. I've heard that rationale used for, you know, for
carry out violent acts to maintain literature. It's called maintaining credibility.
Uh-huh.
So you have to carry out violent acts to maintain literature. It's called maintaining credibility.
Uh-huh.
So you have to carry out violent acts to maintain. Credibility.
Indeed. I've heard that rationale used for, you know, for obviously odious stuff while we're maintaining credibility. Otherwise, we ain't.
So you have to carry out violent acts to maintain credibility.
Indeed. I've heard that rationale used for, you know, for obviously odious stuff while we're maintaining credibility. Otherwise, we ain't got no street. Fred. There was a brilliant study, which is a very difficult one to do, as a rationale used for, you know, for obviously odious stuff while we're maintaining credibility. Otherwise, we ain't got no street cred. Was a brilliant study, which is a very difficult one to do at the time. You can do it much more easily now, by Gore and Sackheim. In Sackheim about 20 years ago, using the fact that we respond to hearing our own voice. With greater arousal than we show when we hear another human's voice. his voice. In both cases, we show physiological arousal. Now, what you can do is have people match for age and sex, read the same boring paragraph from time read the same boring paragraph from Thomas Kuhn's Structure of Scientific Revolution. Chop it up into 2, 4, 6, 12 second segments. Create a master tape where some of the time you're hearing your own voice, a lot of the time you're hearing not. Now then you've got to press a button which says if you think it's yours, and they also had them. press the second button. Age and sex. Read the same boring paragraph from Thomas Kuhn's Structure of Scientific Revolution. Chop it up into 2, 4, 6, 12 second segments. Create a master tape where some of the time you're hearing your own voice, a lot of the time you're hearing not. Now then you've got to press a button which says if you think it's yours, and they also had them press a not. Now then you've got to press a button which says if you think it's yours, and they also had them press a second button, how sure you are. But meanwhile they got the galvanic skin response. Now they discovered two interesting things. First of all, some people denied their own voice some of the time, but the skin always had it right. Some projected their own voice some of the time. The skin always had it right. The deniers denied. The denial, but the projectors half the time were willing to admit afterwards that they think they made the mistake.
What do you think the reason for this? What do you think the reason for that is?
The difference between the projectors and the deniers? Well, I don't have a good way of putting it. To me, when you want to deny reality, you've got to act quickly and get it out of sight. The deniers also showed the highest levels of galvanic skin response to all stimuli. It's like they were primed to do it. Inventing reality a little bit more relaxed enterprise, but I haven't.
It's not as threatening.
Yes. Yeah. Something like that. I haven't thought out a good way to put it, but something along that is the way I've been thinking.